A very big day at Olympic Park swimming pool as gold medals are on the line with some of the fastest events that ever have been held in the Olympic Games coming up. Don Quickie with John Neighbor. We start off the day with the final in the men's 400-meter freestyle. Every qualifier was under the previous Olympic record time. We conclude with the men's 4x100-meter relay. The U.S. could set a world record in that. Overall, John, a very all-star field.
It is a great day for swimming, Don. This could be one of the more exciting sessions, starting off the fastest field, the most competitive field in the 400-meter event ever. Coming right back, Madam Butterfly makes her first appearance. Following that, the men's 200 breaststrokes showing three very good friends from two different countries swimming under the same coach. Last individual event, a young breaststroker has a chance doing something that no one from any country, no country, has ever done before, winning both breaststrokes in one Olympics. And lastly, a very good shot for a world record in an event the United States has never lost.
The first event of the night features the world record holder in the 400-meter freestyle for men, Artur Wodat of Poland and the University of Iowa. Let's spend a moment in time with Artur Wodat.
Artur Wodat first began swimming when he was only 5 years old. He grew up in western Poland, in Poznan, a city of 470,000 people and only 6 indoor swimming pools.
Swimming for a lot of years was fun for me. I just didn't do anything else. And all those first places, all the success, came to me really easy. So I decided that I need to do another step forward to achieve something else, something more.
Wodat tried to get help in the summer of 85. Polish officials put in a request to authorities in the Soviet Union and East Germany.
They probably checked the Leningrad and Berlin for the place for us to stay and to train, but probably they decided that they didn't want us.
In Mission Viejo, California, Coach Terry Stoddard was waiting with open arms. His melting pool has 16 foreign athletes representing 5 countries, including 5 from Poland.
We were wanted here, and our president of Polish swimming asked Terry Stoddard if he would like to keep 2 Polish swimmers for a year to train them. He said, why not? They are more than welcome. Then we decided that America is the place for us.
With Stoddard's help, Wodat became the first Polish swimmer ever to hold a world record. Adjusting to life in the United States hasn't been too difficult. He has a fondness for rock video.
If I had a time, I would probably watch MTV 24 hours a day.
Through an exchange program set up by the Polish American Sports Foundation, Wodat lives with the Tunstall family in Orange County, California.
And this is a very, very good host family. They take really good care of me. They even found a Polish cookbook. They cook Polish food. Of course, they enjoy a lot.
After the Olympics, Wodat plans to enroll at the University of Iowa. Since his arrival in the United States, Artur has unfortunately heard a number of Polish jokes.
If it's a good joke, I laugh with him, you know. If it's a stupid joke, I just don't laugh, you know. Mostly they are stupid, but I've met some couple of good ones. But I don't think we are a bad society, you know. I think we are talented society that could do a lot, you know, on the international scene.
Artur Wodat on the pool deck, the world record holder, 20 years old. So a very leisurely start as the starter now brings him to the block. This the gold medal swim in the men's 400-meter freestyle featuring the world record holder, Artur Wodat.
Starter bringing them to their position. They stand at the back of the blocks. The official says, take your mark, and then they get in the tuck position. At that point, the gun will sound. The horn will sound, I should say. Just imagine the tension, the electricity in their bodies. Tightly wound springs, ready to go.
400 meters, freestyle, 8 lengths of the pool. First start is a good one, and they're away. Swimming for the gold at 400 meters freestyle. Very even start. They all came out of the dive dead even. Matt Setlinski swimming well in lane 8. You see him at the bottom of your screen. Challenging for the lead along with Homer. It's also swimming well up top. Appears to be Arthur Wodat. He's a motorboat in the water. Very, very powerful.
You know, two of the top favorites, the two swimmers from Poland, both train in California at Mission Viejo, the great program under Terry Stoddard. And they are pushing each other along. It's easy to think that you might be able to go a world record time, but if you see the guy in the lane next to you doing it in workout, you better keep up.
Stoddard from Mission Viejo is coaching the Polish team. Pop Szczelny actually graduated from Mission Viejo High School. They're now completing the first 100 meters of men's 400-meter freestyle. Anders Holmert, swimming two up from the bottom of your screen from Sweden, goes to the wall with the lead after 100 meters, and right with him is Matt Setlinski of the USA.
You can't believe this, Don. They're a full second ahead of world record pace, and what's interesting is most of the people in this field like to negative split, which means their back half will be faster than the front half. We're going to shatter a record if this keeps up.
Right now, going out very strong are those two swimmers on your screen. In the near lane, and that's lane 8 in the pool, Matt Setlinski of the USA, next to him in the yellow cap, Anders Holmertz of Sweden. They complete 150 meters. And now, down this length of the pool, they go to the halfway mark.
You know, the freestyle turn is sort of a shoulder roll. It's a sit-up and a shoulder roll all at the same time. Easy to do once in a while, but at the end of a long sprint, a long distance race, those sit-ups hurt like the dickens.
Matt Setlinski, a graduate of the University of Florida, swimming for the lead now. As they come to the halfway point, and we'll look at the 200-meter split, they were well under world record time after 100 meters, and they are now on a world record pace.
Good pace, Setlinski. His coach told us earlier that he wants to go out under 153. He's 152 low. That's good for Setlinski.
And right now, John, Matt Setlinski of the USA has taken lead at the bottom of your screen in lane 8. That is Setlinski in a white cap with the American flag, Homer swimming next to him.
It's a perfect position for Setlinski, being on the outside lane. No one in the center can see him right now. In fact, even if they look, the Swede, Holmertz, is in the way. So Sedlinski's got the rest of the field confused or rather blind to his swimming, and he's going out for it.
Matt Setlinski, having perhaps the swim of his life. A man who has been the best at this event for the USA over the last 5 years, but had a bad qualifying day on 84 and didn't make our Olympic team, and now in 88 he could be going for gold. Matt Setlinski, as they come now to conclude 300 meters of swimming, has the lead. He has increased his margin over Homer. Now 100 meters to swim in the 400-meter freestyle.
You know, that last length, Wodat, the world record holder, was breathing and looking forward at Matt, so I think Wodat sees him. Here comes the race. Wodat now breathing to his right, but he knows he's not in the lead.
Wodat in lane 3. Three down from the top. That's Setlinski from the USA in lane 8. As they now have 60 meters to swim. And Setlinski holding to a half body length lead over Wodat. Wodat gaining some ground and now 50 meters to swim. It's Setlinski of the USA holding the lead. Wodat challenging hard. Also coming on is Homer. Setlinski, Holmertz, and Wodat all together. And look at Duncan Armstrong at the top of your screen, who came from off the pace to set a world record and win the 200-meter freestyle. His coaches said this was his best event, and Duncan Armstrong appears to have taken the lead. Uwe Dassler is also coming on. What a race. To the wall they go. And let's see, it is Uwe Dassler of East Germany in the last 10 meters. Breaks the world record and wins the fastest 400-meter freestyle event ever. Looking at the other finishers. Armstrong of Australia coming from off, finished second, barely. Wodat from Poland was third. And Matt Setlinski of the USA, who led almost the entire way, ended up fourth in the race and out of the medal count. Top three, John, all under the previous world record.
An amazing swim. We told you it'd be a fast heat. It was. Uwe Dassler swimming perhaps the most strategic race of his life. Stayed in the background until the last 20, 30 meters. Uwe Dassler looking extremely strong, mostly in the legs. Uwe Dassler, you see him now, just going under the false start rope. Setlinski's on the bottom, world record holder. Wodat, third from the top. And Duncan Armstrong, the 200 freestyle champion, is way up in the far side. Look at that stroke. It looks rather unorthodox on top, but he's relying greatly on his legs. Dassler with a strong, powerful kick just charged home on the last 50, going from fifth to first in 50 meters. A fantastic swim, and look, he knows that we were overlooking him at the start of this race. he had something to prove, and I think he's going to be a contender in the mile race later in the Olympics.
So a thriller in world record time goes to Uwe Dassler of East Germany, Armstrong of Australia second, Wodat, the previous world record holder, was third, Sedlinski of the USA gets fourth place. For John Neighbor, this is Don Criqui at Olympic Swimming.